You are the men who gave them the power to destroy themselves. And the world is not prepared.
Truman needs to know what's next.
Two.
What's next?
One.
Hello, everyone. This is your good old neighbor Nick Hicks, Spider-Verse and Frozen 2 and Kim Possible Fan 2001. And doing two last night, it was the Super Bowl. And doing two, we got a bunch of trailers just came out from last night. So, honestly, guys, so instead of doing trailer roundup, which I am no longer doing trailer roundup because number one, editing, and number two is the other thing when you saw do. Honestly, I'm not gonna put this in this video. Honestly, guys, just because I'm doing trailer review, it didn't mean trailer roundup will come back. And don't worry, my Q&A will come back maybe this Friday or maybe this month. I'm sorry, and maybe on next Monday. So, honestly, guys, so get ready. Just get ready for your comment, for your question, and you can ask me anything that you want. So, honestly, guys, and honestly, guys, I have no idea when is my last Q&A, which I did, which is the one, it's the one with Nick Hicks, Spider-Verse, and Frozen 2 Fans has won, so, yeah. Anyway, and don't worry, I will bring the Q&A back, because honestly, guys, I'm probably been waiting for the Q&A for a very long time, so don't worry, this is gonna be the very first Q&A of 2024, so yeah. Honestly, guys, and anyway, so today, I'm just going to do a trailer review of every single Super Bowl trailer, like TV spot and all that. Yep, TV spot will count as a trailer. So, hey, guys, and before I get started, honestly, guys, we're going to get to my least favorite, and we're going to talk about the best part at the end of the video. And don't worry, it is not going to be my trailer roundup, because if I do that, this video will be up like at midnight or something like that, because it will take a very long time to upload. So, hey guys, no further ado, let's get this started, and I am so happy that my boy, Chief win, which, thank goodness, hallelujah, because this year, it has to be one of the second best years for Super Bowl, because we have never had a good Super Bowl since 2020, honestly. So, hey guys, no further ado, let's get this trailer review of all the trailer from my least favorite to my favorite at the end. But first, we're gonna start off to my least favorite. No further ado, let's get the game started, shall we? So, you guys, anyway, we have to talk about my least favorite out of the Super Bowl TV spot. But typically, this is not a trailer. This is a TV spot, and I gotta say, it was awful. I am so looking forward to this Despicable Me, and I am so hype. I'm sorry, I was kind of looking forward to what is the TV spot for Super Bowl. Seriously, Women Nation, you just seriously give us a bunch of minions. No offense to the minions, they're funny, but that's the only thing I just got really annoyed. Why in the world that you did a TV spot of all the bunch of minions using AI pictures? Seriously, that is the worst Super Bowl TV spot of 2024, because that TV spot right there, it was cringe. Honestly, guys, not cringe at the minions. It was cringe. It was cringe when minions did that one picture. When the older people do some yoga and there was a bunch of 4 feet. Ew. That is disgusting. Ew. That's disgusting. That's stupid. Anyway, honestly, guys, and to be honest, even I am so looking forward to Despicable Me 4, but I am more excited for Deadpool 3 better than Despicable Me 4. And speak of Deadpool 3, we're gonna get to that very last. Honestly, no way, I'll get to that. Anyway, I do not like the TV spot. Women Nation, I'm not trying to hate on Women Nation, but Women Nation need to get themselves together with the TV spot, because on the guys, some of the TV spot for Illumination, it always been bad. It's always been bad. Like the Minion the Wiser Gru, when on the guys, when we get started of the scene when Gru was putting his Oregi on and the camera shot, in the camera show his butt. Oh my god. It's supposed to be a kids movie. Why in the world you showing that to the kids movie? Why aren't you, are you kidding me? Anyway, honestly, guys, that's why I think Despicable Me 4 is my least favorite out of the Super Bowl TV spot. And to be honest, there were a much better animated film for Super Bowl, like The Inside Out 2, or even Kung Fu Panda 4. Now, that is a way better TV spot than this cringing TV spot. In Ouija Gaming, I'm not saying that I'm not looking forward to this film. And boy, I am so excited because I just want to give this film a chance. But that TV spot when the minions used them, AI, it was completely cringe. And Ouija Gaming, why not want enough to above that you just upload that video? You could, you could just literally watch it on the Wimination YouTube channel. So there was no need to re-upload it, or else Wimination will copyright your video. So no offense to Ouija Gaming, but honestly, guys, sometimes you gotta stop doing it. And honestly, I already know you're marketing of the film, which I understand. But I'm probably Illumination. I'm probably Universal is the biggest thing with copyright. It will copyright you. It will take away your YouTube channel. It will take away all your tools. So, just want to be one, you guys. Anyway, don't let me get started of the last part of the trailer. When they did a Despicable Me 4 and the logo design, it looks absolutely horrible. It looks absolutely god-awful. So god-awful is not even funny at all. Anyway, that logo when they show a Despicable Me 4 when the white screen and when you saw a AI design, I am sorry, but I am not a huge fan of the AI logo design. Every single logo that the AI, it keep messing up the logo. Honestly, guys, they keep messing up with the Disney logo or Pixar logo, or put Pixar out. Oh my god, why would you do that? It's stupid. Anyway, that's why I think Despicable Me 4 is my least favorite out of the Super Bowl. And at the same time, still looking forward to it, but Illumination, get yourself together with the TV spot. Stop with the cringiness and give us a great TV spot. Why in the world did Neptune about that you did not do a TV spot of the Super Mario Bros. Movie during the Super Bowl, but now you did this from last year, which, yeah, honestly, guys, Illumination, gotta get yourself together. Stop with the cringiness. Just give us a Super Bowl without the cringe. It will be amazing. And honestly, guys, I won't mind for the minions because minions are funny. But that's the only thing I just do not like. I do not like from the minions. And to be honest, AI is completely overused these days, because AI can be cool, because I am thinking of making Kim Possible picture as a AI and make it as a real risk it. But like I said, but some of the AI, it keep using the AI for a very wrong reason. So yeah. Honestly, guys, without further ado, let's move on to another TV spot. Let's move on to another thing. I just didn't care for it. Honestly, guys, to be honest, I'm not a huge fan of the Thunder Man. And people, don't hate me, but I'm not a huge fan of the Thunder Man. I'm probably some people in the comment are going to keep saying, "What? You're not a huge fan of the Thunder Man? Oh, on the screen. Oh my god, I hate you." Guys, it's just my opinion about the show. Honestly, guys, at least it's way better than Harry Danger. Like, Harry Danger getting a movie? Oh boy, that is way worse. Honestly, guys, I am not looking forward to it, because Harry Danger is officially one of my least anticipated movie of 2025. And so, you guys, and anyway, let's get to my thought. Sorry about that. Anyway, now let's get to my thought on the, of the official trailer for a new movie based on the Nickelodeon show that came out years ago, which is another than The Thunder Man Return. I am so glad that The Thunder Man is returning, but at the same time, I'm just not looking forward to it, because after I saw the trailer, honestly, guys, I'm just not looking forward to it. Honestly, guys, I just do not care that this is going to be a big movie on Paramount Plus. And to be honest, I don't have Paramount Plus now, so I just no interest. Honestly, guys, I'm just not interested in watching this film, because I'm just not a huge fan of the Thunder Man. And to be honest, I'm just not a huge fan of the modern sorry, of the modern Nickelodeon sitcom, because honestly, guys, we keep getting a bad sitcom from Nickelodeon. I mean, again and again. First, we got Victorious. Second, we got Diggity Dong, which that show's got awful. And the worst Nickelodeon sitcom show, and it's completely kneeling off the confident, which is another day, and here we danger. AKA one of the worst sitcom shows I ever seen, and I would watch a way better sitcom shows. I would watch The Good Place. Now that is way better than most of the sitcom Nickelodeons they ever did for a very long time, honestly. And at the same time, I am so happy that the cast member is completely returning as their characters from The Thunder Man. Honestly, guys, they are grown up now. But at the same time, I'm just not looking forward to it because, honestly, guys, and just like this book of me four, I think this is my second least favorite out of the Super Bowl trailer. And I guess, but I think this film is going to be overrated. But don't worry. I do it, and just like Jane Possible say from Kim Possible for some of the episodes, honestly guys, you know what Jane Possible say? You can't judge everything because of cover. So, honestly guys, I'm not judging this film because of cover. I might give it a chance. Honestly guys, let me tell you my deal. If this film turned be surprising, I might do a review of it. But I swear to monkey, if this film to be a bad movie, I might do a win of it. So, yeah, I might do a win of it. I might put this film as my number two worst movie of the year. So, yeah. Anyway, so let's hope this film will not be a bad film. Because I'm just getting sick of tired of seeing a bad film like most of every single year. Which is getting really freaking annoying. Anyway, honestly guys, enough talk about my least favorite. Now let's get to the awesomeness. Sorry guys, anyway, so the next trailer I'm gonna talk about for the Super Bowl, which is netted in a Super Bowl TV spot of The Fall Guy from the director who brought you The Bullet Train and Deadpool 2. I am so looking forward to it because Ryan Gosling and Emily Blunt, which is the same actress that she was in Oppenheimer as Kitty Oppenheimer, which, guys, I am not joking. That is seriously her name in the characters. So, yeah, it's not Kitty Caswell from Tough Hubby, which I'm not stupid. Anyway, honestly, guys, the main reason why I'm checking this film out is because of the fact that this film starring Ryan Gosling, which I like Ryan Gosling. Honestly, guys, I do enjoy him as Ken from the Barbie movie, which, honestly, guys, I just don't understand why some people think Barbie movie is not a masterpiece. Like, are you kidding me right now? Are you serious? Marketing, you stupid darn it. Anyway, I am so looking forward to The Fall Guy because, number one, Ryan Gosling's in the film, which, to be honest, you know me. I like Ryan Gosling. I do like him in The Notebook what's that movie called, it started him and Zine from Thor, The Nice Guy, I can't forget that film, which I might watch that film pretty soon. And so, you guys, and number two is from the director who brought you Bullet Train, which I do enjoy Bullet Train, and I do really love Deadpool 2, and to be honest, I think Deadpool 2 is a lot better than the first film, which I do like the first film, but I think the sequel is a lot funnier than the first film, honestly. And number three, Emily Blunt. I gotta be honest, but I think Emily Blunt character is my favorite. It's gonna be one of my favorite characters in this film, because Emily Blunt, she looks beautiful, she looks amazing, and she looked absolutely attractive in her ageness, and the action scene looks pretty cool. So cannot wait for this film. So let's hope this film will not be a Rotten Tomato one, which I'm just getting sick of tired of Rotten Tomato nonsense. Like, what is Rotten Tomatoes doing? Is Rotten Tomato hiring a bunch of chimpanzee? Like, are you kidding me? Control your Rotten Tomato rating, you stupid darn it. Anyway, honestly guys, enough talking about this film. Let's talk about for another one. Honestly guys, and now let's get to the one trailer that I absolutely enjoy, which is another than If. I am not joking. That is That is actually the name of the title of the film. Yeah. Anyway, honestly, if it's a movie about imaginary friend, I gotta be honest, but this is a way but imaginary, honestly, this is going to be a way but imaginary friend than the SML video about Bowser Jr. imaginary friend. What is a sequel when Ron and Jeffy just completely destroy Jr.'s imaginary friend? And to be honest, honestly, even that video was really funny, but at the same time, I just got really annoyed when Jeffy's cussing, like, so, oh my god. Anyway, and honestly, guys, the main reason why I'm checking this film out is because Ryan Gosling is in the film, which, I think, oh man, Ryan Reynolds, oh my goodness. Why in the world did I say Ryan Gosling? Honestly, guys, the main reason why I wanted to check this film out is because of the fact that this film starring Ryan Reynolds. I like Ryan Reynolds. He's honestly one of my favorite comedian of all time, honestly, because he's a really funny comedian. And speak of him, we're going to get to his film in a minute. And so, you guys, and Phoebe Waller-Bridge, I am still hoping that this is going to be a way better. I'm sorry. Wes Hope Pukelto will finally redeem herself to that terrible, god-awful Phoebe characters from Indiana Jones and the Terror of the Snorfest, because that film makes me want to fall asleep. Anyway, honestly, guys, that TV spot was really funny, because honestly, guys, do you seriously think that you're going to see the actor that he was in The Quiet Place from the director? Nope, it got replaced from the actor that he was in WandaVision as Jimmy and the other guy for Aquaman and the Lost Kingdom as the as the guy that he was working for, Black Manta. And at the end of the film, he was betraying because he really wanted to see that the ocean and Black Manta is completely destroying it in front of him, which I just feel bad for that guy. And so, yeah. Anyway, Steven Carell is in this film. So, let's hope. Let's hope Steven Carell would be a great character. So yeah. Anyway, I am so looking forward to it. I like Imaginary Friend, which I have Imaginary Friend in my head. So yeah. Anyway, let's get to the Nether Trail we're gonna talk about for this week. Today. Honestly, guys, typically this is not a trailer because I cannot believe Disney lied to us, because Disney said that Inside Out 2 will get a trailer during the Super Bowl. You know what they did? They completely lied. Disney, enough of the lying bullcrap. I really want to see Inside Out 2 as a trailer. Come on, man. Anyway, I'm not trying to hate on Disney, but that's the biggest problem I have for Disney, because every single time they keep saying something, it always not happen, because, honestly, guys, oh my goodness, this is even worse than DreamWorks. It's not making a bunch of marketing for Kung Fu Panda 4, which I don't understand why Troll 3 got more marketing than Kung Fu Panda 4. For Kung Fu Panda 4. So let's hope Kung Fu Panda 4 would not be a box office flop by DreamWorks, just like the Teenage Carnage, which the film came out like 1 year ago. And so yeah. Anyway, guys. So honestly, guys, now let's talk about the TV spot of the Super Bowl, which is then Inside Out 2. I am so looking forward to Inside Out 2. And honestly, guys, Rowley in this film, she works. Fantastic. I gotta say, she looks fantastic, but you can't have a crush on her because she's still underage, huh? She's 12 years old, for goodness sakes. And just because she's a teenager, it didn't mean you have to phone up with her, honestly. And honestly, and Kim Possible and Asha is a different story, because they're both as young adult. But teenage Rowley, you can't fall in love with her. She's underage. So, she's still underage, so I do not care if she's a teenager or bottom line, she's a freaking underage, so, yeah. Anyway, and I got a bad feeling that Troll Band Together fan is going to fall in love with, you're going to fall in love with teenage Rowley. Oh my goodness, I am not looking forward to his fan art, man. Yeah, his fan art is really disgusting, which I might do a part 2 rant of his fan art, which most of his fan art is really disgusting. Especially he have audacity to make a fan art of, Kate Bishop kissing Cam's butt. Ew, don't do that. That is disgusting. You're nasty. Oh my goodness. It's just like Queen Brown from Family Guy is like, oh my god, you're nasty. Yup, Troll Band Together fan is It's freaking nasty. please don't do that, okay? Please do not make a fan art of Kim kissing, do not make a fan art of some of the characters kissing Kim's butt. Yeah, stop that. It's a disgusting. Stop it. Stupid. Anyway, honestly, guys, top of that, I'm so looking forward to it. Inside Out 2, it's going to be a lot better than the first film, which I like the first film, which I think the sequel will be a lot better. So let's hope the sequel will be like Incredibles 2, which I really hope this film will say Pixar. But if this film bomb, it can show that Pixar is doomed. Because they have one simple job, but if they add some bunch of stuff that people do not like the lesbian, gay, and the KKK, and the YGP, people will have a problem with it, and this film will be a box office bomb just like Ratio, which I do not want to see this film to be a box office bomb. Like, are you kidding me right now? And why in the world of Neptune Above, back in 9 years ago when the first film came out and the Minions movie made more money than Inside Out, which no offense to the Minions, but Inside Out deserved more money. So let's hope this film would make a lot money than Despicable Me 4. And I'm not saying Despicable Me 4 would be a box office bomb, which I do not want that to happen. Anyway, I just want Despicable Me 4 will have a okay box office. Like, okay box office. But, honestly, honestly, guys, it can show the box office is completely manipulating Lumination and giving them money. And I'm probably like, oh my god, I feel bad. And Pixar, I don't feel bad for you. You, honestly, guys, you did it by yourself. Anyway, honestly, guys, in the TV spot of Inside Out 2 is amazing. My Joy, she's really awesome. And my favorite is Disguise. Man, I love Disguise since the beginning, because I think Disguise is honestly one of my favorite members of the Inside Out, which Disguise is really attractive, honestly. And so, yeah. Anyway, and Sadness is really Sadness, no pun intended. And Anger, angry all the time. Yep, that's his characters. Anyway, and Theo, it's a Theo. Anyway, and honestly, I don't mind the new voice actor and actress for Theo in this Disguise, because thank goodness to Lord that the original actress who was the voice of Disguise from the first Inside Out is not in this film, which I'm probably the Pixar say the reason why is because of the fact that, oh my goodness, that actress was making Velma show, which, you, oh my goodness, thank goodness that show is out of existence, and now people will forget that show even exists. Honestly, guys, I'm probably some people will show the Velma show. I'm probably like, what is this? I don't remember this crap. Yeah. Anyway, let's keep Velma show as a dead topic. Let's keep it that way. Right. Walking in the closet door. Anyway, that was my thought of Inside Out 2 TV spot. Disney, next time, do not why, okay? Honestly, if Disney Y about Moana 2 trailer would come, I am going to be very disappointed, because I'm just getting sick of talking about Disney Y to us all the time. They keep doing this all the time, man. So I really hope Bob Arco is not doing it, because I really hope Bob Arco is not doing it. But if I hear him, he's doing it, I'm going to be really disappointed, which I just do not want to lose trust for that guy, because that is the same guy that he give us a bunch of food, like Frozen 3 and Toy Story 5. Ooh, get that Toy Story 5 out of my face. Anyway, let's hope Inside Out 2 will not be disappointed, and let's hope this film will save the Pixar film, which honestly, so far, Turning Red is doing okay box office, but Soul, it did pretty bad, so... Yeah, I'm probably Pixar is doomed. So what's up this film will say Pixar, because sequel make more money than original film. Now let's move on to another trailer, which I'm going to talk about. Well, typically this is not a trailer, and just, oh my goodness, and just like Inside Out 2, DreamWorks, Will is Kung Panda 4 official trailer 2? We've been waiting for it. How in the world did Neptune Above, that troll band together, more like troll bandit together, got more marketing than Kung Fu Panda 4? Oh my goodness, please do not tell me that Kung Fu Panda 4 would be a box office bomb. Please do not. please do not let that happen. Like, are you kidding me right now? All the guys, oh my goodness. Draymond, you better not. Oh my goodness. You better not give Kung Fu Panda 4 a lacking marketing. Or else it's going to be becoming one of the worst marketing for a DreamWorks film. And for goodness sake, this is even worse than Teenage Carnage marketing. Anyway, my thought on the Super Bowl TV spot of Kung Fu Panda 4. It looks really fun. And to be honest, I'm a huge fan of a Kung Fu Panda movie. The first film is really a masterpiece. And the sequel is honestly, it's one of my favorite DreamWorks films I ever seen. Next to The Prince of Egypt, The Prince of Egypt, Puss in Boots: The Last Wish, or even Rise of the Guardians. Anyway, and my boy, Taiwan, came back. Hallelujah. Yep, I am so happy that the legendary villain of Kung Fu Panda from the first film, Taiwan, has come back, which I am so glad that they brought back Taiwan. So let's hope they brought back for the villain from the sequel and the third film, which I won't mind it because, honestly, guys, I'm part of this film is going to be like Spider-Verse. And to be honest, after I heard the news about this film is going to be like Spider-Verse, I was like, DreamWorks, sign me in. And DreamWorks, please make more marketing. Enough making more marketing for Megamind 2. Nobody care about Megamind 2. We care about Kung Fu Panda 4. Now, that is a way better sequel than that cheap cash grab Megamind 2. Guys, I like Megamind for the first film, but the sequel, it looks freaking god awful, which, yeah, that film's gonna suck. Anyway, and that film is gonna come out on March 1st, so yeah, no thank you. Honestly, guys, I would have watched Doom Part 2 way better than watching Megamind 2 because Megamind 2 is a bunch of cheapskate. Anyway, and speaking of cheapskate, Mr. Krabs is a cheapskate. Shut up. Anyway, that's my thought on Kung Fu Panda 4 Super Bowl TV spot. So, we gotta keep this quick because this video is gonna get really long, so let's move on. Anyway, so on the guys, I am so sorry that I am so late for this one. So today I'm doing my trailer review of A Quiet Place Day One, which is a prequel to the Quiet Place movie. To be honest, I have never seen some of the Quiet Place movie, which I was I do remember almost watching it. But honestly, guys, I'm probably someone of my friend of mine said, Nick, you're watching a Quiet Place? You're watching a horror movie? Honestly, guys, I didn't see you watching horror movies, and I just really turned it off because I just don't want them watching. Honestly, I just don't want them know that I've been watching horror movies, for goodness sakes. And so, yeah, I am so excited for it. And to be honest, before I watched it, I would definitely watch the first Quiet Place and the sequel Quiet Place leading up to this because this is a prequel of how they ripped off and how the first film and the second film didn't get made. Because, to be honest, the pop culture committee was right. This film is kind of feel like I'm watching an action film than a horror movie, which it has some horror element, but this film didn't feel like I'm watching a horror movie. This film is kind of fun. I'm sorry, kind of remind me I am watching an action film than a horror movie, honestly. And so, yeah, guys, I am so looking forward to it, so let's move on. Anyway, guys, now let's talk about the Super Bowl trailer, which is other than the Monkey Man. Anyway, this film is kind of remind me of John Wick. Honestly, guys, this film have the same concept of the John Wick movie, and I'm a huge fan of the John Wick movies. But honestly, guys, I won't mind this film will be our next John Wick movie because John Wick died in the fourth film. So yeah. Anyway, guys, and it's from the director from Deepana, which I have no idea. Anyway, it's from the producer of Jordan Peele, which Jordan Peele, look to your man. Anyway, the action scene looks pretty brutal, and the storyline looks completely original, because let's hope this film would be a box office success, because it's a Monkey Man. If you have a name in the title, kids, do not watch it, because just because you saw the Monkey Man in the title, it didn't mean this film is a kids movie. I should do it. Anyway, once again, we're going to cut that out. Anyway, now let's move on to another trailer. Which is another thing, honestly, I'm going to talk about the new trailer, which is coming on Thanksgiving, which is another thing, The Witcherton. Witcherton. Yeah, Witcherton. guys, I have never seen the Broadway show, which I do really want to. I do really want to watch that Broadway show of the Richardson, because that had my goal that she was the voice of Elsa on the guy, and now she's playing the witch in the Broadway shows. But Minzy, she's not in this film, which I was completely disappointed that they did not brought back to her, which on the guy they got replaced from the one black actress, so on the I won't mind. Anyway, and Rihanna Grande is in this film. I didn't even know that Rihanna Grande is in this film, because after I saw the Super Bowl of this film, and I was like, what is this? What is it? Is that the actress from the Ghostbusters Afterlife? So after I worked on my research, and after I saw Rihanna Grande in this, and I was like, man, I'm probably Rihanna Grande is joining the movie Generation. Yeah. Anyway, I am so looking forward to it. And the one thing I was completely shocked about this, Why in the world this film was playing in the Super Bowl for a TV spot? This film is coming out on November. Like, how does that make sense? And honestly, guys, and this film is coming out the same day of Moana 2. So that's the big chip in. So what's up, Moana 2 will be a box office hit. And no offense to this film, but what's up, Moana 2 will be a box office hit. It has to be. After the okay box office of Disney Wish. It's not the best, but it's decent. Alright guys, now let's move on to the other trailer. Alright guys, and now we're going to talk about the new trailer based on the original film called The Twist Sister. Ooh, the tornado movie. Anyway, I have never seen the original film from Steven Spielberg, which I might watch it because I'm a huge fan of Steven Spielberg. So yeah. Anyway, on to guys. So after I heard they're making a remake of this film, and I was like, really? Is that necessary? And after I heard the news that they are hiring the guy that he was in Top Gun as a hangman, I gotta say, I was definitely in, because I am so excited for it. And after I saw the trailer, this is going to be a way better remake. And I gotta say, this film is going to have the same. It's going to have the same nostalgia, just like the original film. And to be honest, stay tuned for my review of the Twister, the tornado movie. Stay tuned for that. Leading up to this, because this film is coming out on July, which we have too many films coming out on July. Like, first Deadpool 3, second it was Despicable Me 4, and now we got this. So yeah. Anyway, that was my thought on this trailer. So let's move on to another trailer. So hey guys, so the another trailer we're gonna talk about, which is Netherin, the Kingdom of the Planet of the Ape. To be honest, I'm a huge major fan of the Planet of the Ape movie. And thanks to Miss Wells got me into for the Planet of the Ape movie. Because honestly, I do remember back in years ago that Miss Wells bought a Planet of the Ape movies, and we had movie days. And when I watched it, and I was like, man, I love that film. And to be honest, I did watch the third film because I was originally watching the third film at school, but then too I had to move to the different classroom, so I had to watch it at my home. And so yeah, and after I watch it, I am just looking forward to see this four of the installment for the Planet of the Apes movies. And Andy Serkis, I gotta say, but Andy Serkis, it's kind of not being this film, because a part of this film is like a prequel after The Rise of the Planet of the Ape came out. So yeah. Anyway, I am so looking forward to it. And I know some people having a crush that one female character that she was in the trailer. To be honest, I was almost gonna have a crush on her, but doing too, she's a younger, a lot younger actress. I gotta be honest, can't have a crush on her, because I gotta check her age first, and then have a crush on her, because on the guy, found love with Kim Possible and Aja is a different story, because at least they both as a young adult, honestly. But the girl that she was in the Kingdom of the Planet of the Ape trailer, I gotta be honest, but she's cute, but I can't say the H-O-T, which... Yeah, I don't want to say it, which, you know, I gotta make myself like a freaking pedophile, you ask me. Anyway, and there was a scene when, I'm sorry, and, honestly, there was a scene of the, I'm sorry, there, honestly, there was a scene of the King Ape I mean, Akeem Ape, which is the main antagonist, was say, "It's the Wonderful World." Oh my goodness, what the heck is this? A Madagascar and Funny Dory? Anyway, it's a Wonderful War. What the heck is it? Madagascar and Funny Dory? Anyway, that was my thought on the Kingdom of the Planet of the Apes movie. I am so looking forward to it. I'm a huge fan of the first film, second film, and even the third film. And the third film should have ended right there. But due to Disney have the right to own this film. So what's up, Disney will not screw this movie up, because I just do not trust Disney. I'm sorry. Honestly, I do not trust Disney with the 20th Century Studio movie, because have you never seen some of the Home Alone? I'm sorry. Have you never seen of some movie called Home Sweet Home Alone, or even Night in the Museum animated movie? And have you never seen of The Cheap Robot Adoption, which that film is based on the original film, which thank goodness that film is doing on Disney Plus. So I really hope Disney Plus would do the same thing with Home Sweet Home Alone, or even Night in the Museum, which nobody cares about that crap. And in Diary of the Wimpy Kid, yeah, honestly guys, I won't mind that film and get removed, because I just do not care what the Diary of the Wimpy Kid animated movie these days. So hey guys, Deadpool fan and Marvel fan in general, get ready for the final trailer that I'm gonna talk about for this week, Super Bowl trailer. Are you ready? Let's do it. So the last trailer we're gonna talk about for tonight, which is none other than a official trailer plus a big game spot, which is none other than Deadpool 3, aka Deadpool and Wolverine. Thank goodness it did not call Deadpool and Friends, because when I heard that title, it's kind of reminded me of Barney and Friend, Thomas and Friend, or even Garfield Friend, which calling Deadpool and Friend is a, honestly, it's a pretty weird title for a Red Law comic book movie, honestly. And this is going to be the very first MCU movie have some odd rating movie. Hallelujah. Thank goodness MCU is doing some mature content. And honestly guys, no offense to MCU, but some of the MCU comedy have got to stop, honestly. Because after I rewatched Thor Love and Trash last year, and that film was completely cringe. So I'm not rewatching that film ever again. Anyway, yeah, honestly guys, the more I think about Love and Trash, Honestly, guys, I'm not trying to hate on that film, but I really wanted to put that film as the worst MCU movie, because it was awful. But Doom 2 has some good element, so I think Iron Man 2 is way worse. It's way worse than Love and Trash. But don't worry, it's in my second worst MCU movie ever I have seen. Anyway, I am so looking forward to Deadpool 3. Because the first film was really funny, and the sequel is honestly one of the most funniest comedy movie of 2018. And honestly, just like the first film, the first film is one of the most funniest comedy movie of 2016. Because happy 8th anniversary to Deadpool 1, because Deadpool 1 came out on February 12, 2016. Because it's been 8 years when the first Deadpool movie came out. I'm getting too old for this crap. Anyway, and there was the last part of the trailer when Deadpool himself was trying to get up, and the legendary Wolverine came back with the original suit. And honestly guys, and when Deadpool said, "Hey, can you give me a hand? Wolverine open his crawl, and Deadpool say, "Never mind." And Wolverine was about to stab Deadpool, and thank goodness they did not spoil it, because I really want to keep it as a surprising. And honestly, this film is going to be, it's going to be one of the biggest movie of the year. Why? Because this film, people have not been excited for an MCU movie since the Avengers Infinity War, the Avengers Endgame, or even Spider-Man No Way Home. And yes, you can say whatever you want about Doctor Strange and the Multiverse of Madness. At first, people were looking forward to it because it was not reactionary. As the Avengers Infinity War and the Avengers Endgame. Because I just really want MCU trailer reaction. I just really want MCU to get more hype. I mean, more hype than hanging on MCU. So let's hope, Phantom Menace will shut the crap up about it, because I'm just getting sick of tired of the MCU haters, because the MCU haters are completely bunch of monkey. Like, oh my goodness, shut up. Anyway, I am so looking forward to Deadpool 3. And this is going to be the second movie, the second rated R movie I will ever saw in theaters. Because my first rated R movie I saw in theaters, which is another than Joker, starting Joker Phoenix. And so, yeah, and I am very disappointed. I am very disappointed that we did not get a first look of the Joker 2, which, yeah, I'm probably Joker 2 will get a wacky marketing. So, Warner Brothers, I already know you're busy. But let's hope David Zazel will not delete Joker 2. If he do that, I'm going to be mad. Anyway, everything from this trailer is amazing. Like, the story is really, it's really amazing. Deadpool himself, performed by Ryan Reynolds, is so amazing once again. And his new suit looks very colorful. Very colorful. Because that's what Deadpool is all about. Anyway, and there was a scene... when Deadpool was doing his gun, training, and when you saw the 20th Century Studios logo was falling in the ground, I got sad, but I got a feeling that Deadpool went back in time, will kill every single terrible Marvel character, like Fantastic 2015. But I will be laughing my butt off when Deadpool will go back in time in Fantastic Four 2015, and he will completely kill every single characters in Fantastic Four 2015. Which, if he do that, I will be I won't be cheering. But I will be laughing my butt off, because that, oh my goodness, that's what Fantastic get for releasing that film, which is going to be one of the worst movies from 2015. It even wasn't heckin' back. Anyway, I am so hyped for Deadpool 3. I am so looking forward to it, because I am so looking forward to it. I got a Deadpool plush over here. So, please want this film to be a hit. Please, we need Deadpool to save the MCU. Apparently, Captain Marvel didn't save the MCU. They really destroyed the MCU. But I like the Marvel. But I was just saying it for the Phantom Menace, which, honestly, when the Marvel came out, the Marvel didn't do well, the box office, which, yeah, oh my goodness, I just feel so bad for Billy Watson. Billy Watson do not deserve that kind of hatred. And I gotta be honest, but I know people are gonna hate me in the comment, but I do not care. But I think Billy Watson is my second most underrated actress in Hollywood. My number one is Richard Zangwin. Yep, I like Richard Zangwin. Some haters, fight me in the comment. Anyway, honestly, guys, that was my trailer review of every single TV spot and trailers from the Super Bowl. And I gotta be honest, but this year's Super Bowl has to be one of the second best years for Super Bowl. It's even better, just like the 2020 Super Bowl will always be my favorite Super Bowl out of the history of the Super Bowl. And to be honest, This year have been a blast, honestly. Like the commercial when the Friends casting, like Jennifer Aniston, which I love Jennifer Aniston. She is really beautiful. And so, yeah, and the actor that he was in Madagascar as Melman. So, yeah. Anyway, they do a crossover of that. And I was so happy when they do there was the other Super Bowl commercial when Ben Affleck was doing this rapping about Dunkin' Donut. Oh my goodness, you didn't see him as a rapper, which I really hope he could be a rapper someday, which I would be funny. It would be a lot better than Megan Thee Stallion and Cardi B. Can't stand a witch. I can't stand a witch. Your witchness. Anyway, if you enjoyed this video, if you want to see more of this longer video, another longer video, which I like longer video because longer video will make my energy, will make this video as a unique and amazing. So yeah, if you enjoyed this video, if you want to see more of this, please, I highly recommend you hit the subscribe button, turn notification, and share the video with your whole family. So tell me which is your favorite out of the Super Bowl TV spot, and tell me which is your least favorite. Come below and let me know. And if you're not looking forward to Deadpool 3, I totally respect your opinion. But for me, Deadpool 3 is going to be the biggest movie of the year. Not Despicable Me 4, and definitely not, definitely not The Thunder Man Return, which I really hope those films would not be biggest movie of the year. I just want Deadpool 3 to be the biggest movie of the year, because MCU got one thing to do. Like having Deadpool to save the MCU. So let's hope Deadpool 3 will get a box office success. So let's hope Deadpool 3 will make a lot more money than Despicable Me 4. And kind of inside out too, honestly. So you guys, have a great night, everyone. And I see you next... I'm sorry. I almost said the cuss word. Anyway, we'll try again. All the time now. Have a great night, everyone. And I see you guys next time. And once again, adios. And good night.